This course covers using a digger derrick to dig a hole and set a pole. We will also discuss using pole pullers to remove wood poles. It is intended for trained, qualified operators only and is not a substitute for general training. Before you begin, carefully read the unit operator's manual and refer to the manufacturer's manuals to properly operate any of the tools shown here. Follow any applicable safe work practices and your employer's work rules for handling, setting, and removing poles. This includes using insulating gloves and other insulating protective equipment when required. Survey the job site for hazards prior to starting work. Hold a job briefing to address any hazards at the site and to make sure all workers inspect and properly use the appropriate PPE. At a minimum, workers should wear head, foot, and eye protection, along with suitable gloves and other PPE required by their employer. Prepare your digger derrick for work by completing a pre-operational inspection as directed by the operator's manual. Check winch, auger, and wind-up sling condition during the inspection. When you're ready to dig, set up and level the unit as directed by the operator's manual. Choose a position within reach of the hole location, which allows for boom retraction or extension while digging. To unstow the auger, start by fully retracting the intermediate boom. The intermediate boom must be retracted to engage with the auger assembly when it unstows. Extend the upper boom enough to keep the winch line clear of the auger assembly and hoses. Next, raise the boom to approximately 45 degrees. This helps protect workers on the ground if the auger wind-up sling breaks while unstowing the auger. Rotate the boom toward a clear area, free from obstructions and personnel. Do not allow anyone to enter the auger swing area while unstowing or stowing the auger. With the digger in low speed, slowly take up any slack in the wind-up strap and unload the auger latch. Safely unstow the auger. Always use low speed when unstowing and stowing the auger. Extend the intermediate boom at least 18 inches before starting to dig. To keep the hole vertical while digging, retract the intermediate boom as the auger is lowered. You may also need to rotate or extend the boom during the dig. Use an observer to help you keep the auger vertical. Use low speed to dig holes. The auger works more efficiently and delivers more torque in low speed, reducing wear and tear on the unit. Use the foot throttle or engine speed control just enough to allow for maximum digger function speed. While the auger digs, boom down gradually, keeping steady pressure on the auger. Be ready to adjust downward force as soil conditions change. Do not use excessive downforce. Too much downforce can corkscrew the auger into the ground, causing overloads and side loads on the unit. This can damage the unit. If this happens, stop digging. Use the clean function and boom up until the auger is rotating freely in the hole. Then, resume digging. When it's time to remove the dirt from the auger, raise the auger from the hole. With the auger stopped, shift to high speed. Hold the auger control in the dig position and use the shake function to rapidly reverse auger rotation. This helps dislodge dirt from the auger. If your unit is not equipped with the shake function, alternate rapidly between dig and clean to help remove dirt. To stow the auger, fully retract the intermediate boom and shift the auger to low speed. With the auger tip firmly on the ground, have a ground worker attach the wind-up sling to the auger. Clear personnel from the auger swing area, then carefully use the dig function to wind up the auger. While winding up the auger, raise the boom to approximately 45 degrees. The sling should wind up just above the attachment point, so that it remains clear of the auger latch when stowed, but below the flange at the top of the auger shaft. If required on your unit, open the latch as the auger approaches the stow bracket. After the auger is stowed, carefully use the clean function to unwind the auger until it rests on the latch. This relieves strain on the wind-up sling during roading. Now you're ready to set the pole in position. Before lifting the pole, make sure there are no overhead obstructions or exposed electrical hazards that will contact the pole as you position it. Pin the pole guides and boom flares to the end of the boom section you will use to handle the pole. Typically, this will be the upper boom. Confirm the weight of the pole and rigging does not exceed unit load chart capacity at any point in the planned lift. Inspect the sling before each use and check that the capacity tag is legible. The sling must have enough capacity to safely carry the weight of the pole. Place the sling above the balance point of the pole. One rule of thumb is to put the sling approximately one-third the pole length from the butt end of a bare pole. This makes the pole easier to handle once it is suspended because the butt will not be as heavy. It also allows more winch rope below the boom tip, reducing the risk of tube locking. Some situations may require different techniques to balance and safely maneuver the pole. Follow your employer's work methods. If a cross arm or other hardware is installed, you may need to adjust the sling position to account for the added weight. Once the lift begins, the operator may not leave the controls with the load suspended. Do not lift the load over personnel, and do not allow personnel between the digger derrick and the load. Serious injury or death could occur. Lift the pole while moving the boom as needed to keep the winch line vertical. Do not side load the boom. To reduce hazards to ground personnel, try to prevent excessive movement of the pole butt during the lift. Keep the pole butt on the ground until the pole is safely suspended and the pole guides are closed around the top of the pole. As the pole nears the boom tip, open the pole guides and tilt them so they are perpendicular to the pole. When the pole nears the vertical position, have the ground person maneuver the top of the pole into the pole guides. Close the pole guides enough to control the top of the pole, but do not clamp or bind the pole. Pole guides are not intended to clamp, lift, or move the pole. They're intended to control the top of the pole while it is being moved, set, or removed. Once the pole is safely within the pole guides, do not open the pole guides or winch down far enough to free the pole. The pole could drop and swing, causing death or serious injury. Move the pole over the hole, then boom down to lower the pole into the hole. Retract the boom and pay in winch line as necessary to keep the pole vertical. Orient the pole correctly. Then, use a hydraulic or manual pole tamp to pack dirt around the pole until it is firmly set. Various soil conditions or pole-setting compounds may require different procedures. Follow your employer's work rules for setting poles. Keep the winch line snug and pole guides in place until the pole is firmly set. Here are some things to keep in mind when setting, moving, or removing poles near energized power lines. Use insulating gloves when handling the pole. Take all necessary precautions to avoid contact with energized power conductors or equipment. Remain outside the minimum required clearances from energized objects. If the possibility of electrical contact exists, consider the entire truck to be energized. Keep unauthorized persons out of the work area. During heavy rain, sleet, or wet snow, take additional steps to protect workers, depending on the voltages involved. With the winch line in use, dielectrically rated units cannot provide protection from electrical contact, even with the fiberglass boom extended. Next, we'll discuss using two common types of pole pullers. The tools and methods shown here are only for removing wood poles. Poles made with other materials may require different removal methods. Inspect the pole before removal. Rotten or damaged poles may be unsafe to remove with a pole puller. Poles must be loose in the ground before lifting them with a digger derrick. Using the Digger Derrick to lift, rotate, push, or pull a pole that is still stuck in the ground can severely overload and damage the unit. It may also cause sudden, unexpected movement of the unit or pole, risking injury or death for nearby workers. Pole pullers help break a pole free from the ground before removing it. This allows the Digger Derrick to lift the pole more easily out of the hole. When removing a pole, first, estimate the weight of the pole and verify it will not exceed the load capacity of the unit or rigging. Check for overhead electrical hazards or obstructions that could contact the pole, rigging, or the boom during pole removal. Position a sling on the pole high enough to ensure the butt of the pole will be heavier than the top once the pole is clear of the hole. The sling position should allow enough winch line to keep the line snug without too blocking at the boom tip as the pole is lifted. There should also be enough pole above the sling point to remain within the pole guides. Close the pole guides around the pole, but do not use them to grip or pull the pole. Inspect the pole puller cylinder, fittings, and hydraulic lines for dirt, leaks, wear, or damage. Check the tool, chain, and base for damage, excessive wear, elongation, bending, or cracks. If any discrepancies are found, do not use the puller until it is properly repaired. Clear and level the ground next to the pole before positioning the puller. This allows level support for the puller. If possible, avoid setting up the puller between the truck and the pole. If the ground cannot be made level, use suitable material, such as wood or outrigger pads, to provide a level, firm surface under the base of the pole puller. The entire base must be firmly supported to prevent bending. Remove the pole puller from the unit or storage location and set it on the ground. Both types of pullers use a chain assembly and hydraulic cylinder to grip and lift the pole. We'll look first at setting up the Altec pole puller. Set the puller base on the ground or supporting materials so that the round bar on the base is next to the pole. Place the pole puller on the base so the curved bracket on the bottom of the cylinder is located over the round bar on the base. Place the D-ring on the puller chain over the lug on the rod end of the cylinder. Wrap the chain tightly around the pole one time. Insert a link from the free end of the chain into the slot of the lug, above the D-ring. Do not use more than one wrap around a pole, and do not make a choke chain around the pole. This could cause the chain to break with great force. The chain could fly off the pole and seriously injure nearby personnel. Now, let's look at setting up the Husky Tiger pole puller. If using the optional pole puller pad, place it on level ground or properly leveled material with the curved portion around the pole. Set the base plate in between the four bushings on the pad to prevent the unit from sliding while pulling the pole. If the optional pad is not used, set the base directly on suitable materials which can keep the base from moving. Place the curved ram end of the cylinder on the base plate centering mount with the cylinder upright and the couplers pointed away from the pole. Slide the swivel plate assembly down the cylinder until it rests on the shoulder at the base of the cylinder. Raise the chain hook swivel bar and confirm the latch hook locks in place. Install the chain with minimum slack by attaching to each of the chain hook castings. Then, insert the back plate between the pole and the chain. Release the hook latch, allowing the chain bar to drop into the lower lifting position. This creates chain tension and secures the back plate and chain around the pole. While using the Husky Tiger puller, do not exceed 2800 PSI hydraulic pressure. With the puller set up, it's time to connect the hydraulic tool circuit hoses. On some units, you may need to bleed off any pressure trapped in the tool circuit hoses before connecting to the puller. Do this by turning off the tool's circuit and moving the tool's directional control back and forth. With the tool's circuit off, unroll the hoses from the tool hose reel. Inspect and clean the hydraulic couplers before and after each use. Connect the return hose to the puller first to prevent pressure buildup inside the puller. Then, connect the pressure line to the puller. Clear all personnel from the area before extending the pole puller cylinder. Turn on the tool's circuit and extend the puller cylinder. As the cylinder extends, the chain will tighten and start lifting the pole. Keep the winch line snug at all times. If the pole is still embedded in the ground, reverse the tool's circuit to retract the cylinder. Reposition the puller and chain and repeat the cylinder extension until the pole is loose from the ground. For the Husky puller, pull the top handle of the black cylinder away from the pole to be sure the swivel plate is disengaged from the pole before retracting. If the chain becomes too tight to unhook, remove the clip and pin on the chain hook castings to release the chain. Retract the cylinder, then reposition the swivel plate and back plate as previously described. Repeat these steps until the pole can be moved freely with the Digger Derrick. Before lifting the pole out of the hole, remove the puller assembly, chain, and base out of the way. Clear personnel from around the pole and winch up to lift the pole out of the hole. Do not let personnel get between the pole and unit or another obstruction. The pole could swing as it lifts clear of the hole, causing death or serious injury. When removing a pole, do not rotate the Digger Derrick from side to side. Do not push or pull the pole with the boom tip or pole guides. This will damage the unit and could cause serious injury. Do not attempt to remove a pole that is not within the unit's load capacity. If necessary, reposition the booms or the unit to ensure the load remains within capacity through the whole range of operation. The hydraulic overload protection system only protects the unit from structural overload, not instability. Following these steps will help you stay safe and reduce wear and tear on your Altec Digger Derrick.